Project have gone from performing killer covers to making monster hits, like this one with Hayley Steinfeld. They've cemented their place as a must-see live act with huge shows both here and abroad. Their collab with 660 went 7 times platinum and became a hit in Australia too, where they're currently based. Tomorrow, they're set to drop their long-awaited second album, Upside, ahead of a fresh run of New Zealand shows this summer. Joining us now from Sydney, can we welcome Sian and Matt, Drax Project? Guys, congrats on the new album. How long have you been beavering away on this one?
Oh, we've been building a dam for about 5 years now. It's been a fun process, though. We're enjoying it. Yeah.
And you've been an Aussie for much of this year. Aussie can be traditionally quite hard to crack for New Zealand acts. Are they being nice to you?
They're making fun of our accents, but ultimately, you know, I think they're enjoying our music.
We played on a boat last night on the Sydney Harbour, cruising underneath the bridge, played the new album.
That's so fun.
Front to back, and it was one of those nights that I think we'll probably remember forever, as cliche and corny as that sounds.
It was hectic.
That's right.
Hectic. It's mad.
How hectic are you talking? Did everyone stay on board, or did some people jump over the side?
No, there was debauchery, there's walking the plank, there was a lot of things going on.
Sian, who's our singer, something came over him, and this is not a lie. He said about 4 times from the stage, walk the plank, walk the plank. And they pointed at a random person and just said, walk the plank.
So you're learning to talk like pirates, but are you learning to talk like Aussies as well? Any slang terms you've picked up while you're over there?
Yeah, honestly, just like mad and hectic.
What's the difference, Jesse?
The difference between Australian slang and New Zealand slang, you mean?
Between Australian slang and pirates.
Oh, yeah. It's a fair point.
So when you started out, you did heaps of covers at your live shows, which we all were obsessed with, but now you've got so many great songs, do you even bother to do the covers?
It's honestly a conversation we have every time, like, do we still play our covers? And it's a weird one, eh?
I think we'll always play at least one cover in our shows. We started off Sian and I busking, drum, sax, Drax on the streets of Courtney Place. And at this point now, we're probably at like a 95-5 split, originals to covers.
You guys have actually been with us from the very start, the last 7 years. We've checked in with you every so often. Is it interesting for you to look back at how far you've come in that time?
Yeah, absolutely. And you guys have been very, very good to us, having us in multiple times, running stories on us and really inflating everything about us, so we appreciate that. But looking back 7 years till now, man, it's actually pretty unbelievable.
I don't even know what happened.
Yeah, it's been a real blur. I mean, 7 years ago we released our first EP that we recorded at Fitzadea Polytechnic. That was where Ben, our guitarist, was studying at the time. And yeah, that was our first EP, and now we're releasing our second album. And yeah, life's good at the moment.
Sian and Matt, absolute legends. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks for having
us. Thank you, guys.
A pair of little legends. It's been great to follow them over the last 7 years. They do have their new album, as I mentioned. It's called Upside. That comes out tomorrow, and we can all get our tickets, and so can you guys, for their New Zealand tour. They're available right now as well.